Canadian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
The aftermath of every social revolution brings about change. Cultural norms and landmarks shift as our minds and hearts expand beyond the familiar. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose in the land of the living. This is our time to renew, revive, and restore the hope lost to the busyness of life. This is our time to dig again and rebuild from the storms of our past on a solid footing that holds. Welcome to The Foundation.
The Foundation. Foundation.
Grounding your company, The Foundation. Don't believe me, just watch, baby. Just watch this thing, how we gonna make this happen. It is the weekend, baby. It's Christmas time. I didn't hear people saying things, but eggnog and Mr. Boston, and they want pumpkin spice latte and pie and all these things. It's Christmas time. We are in the city, in the land of the living. We got to give praise, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have a great show for you today. I want to thank all the persons that continue to sponsor the show. They are Alive, Bahamas Welding and Fire, Burger King, Carrie's Fabric and Uniform Store, Commonwealth Bank, the Deposit Insurance Corporation, Grand Bahama News, Marco's Pizza, and Ron's Electric Motors. I got to be able to read this for you guys. The Black Friday DQ. This Black Friday, DQ got the sweetest deal, 50% off all cake, boxes of DQ sandwiches, Dilly bars, Buster bars, and fall blizzards, and delicious 100% beef hot dogs. Continuing our deals, on Cyber Monday, there will be 50% off of our $5 gift cards. To be eligible for the Cyber Monday sale, you must click the link on the Facebook page or Instagram to receive your QR code that you must present in the store. For more information, please follow us on social media platforms or ask a member of staff in store. That's wild, ladies and gentlemen. It is Black Friday. Everything on the sidewalk, everything's out there. Black Friday just for a little bit before government payday, right? I know you're looking at that salivating. My God, if I had to get paid today. You all need to stop it. Let's just be very clean and decent as we do this, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, it is November 24th, Friday, here in the land of the living. So happy to be with you. Make sure you pick up your Guardian newspaper. No concerns over my political fortunes. My God. Pintard insists he's stable as leader despite election loss. Opposition wants answers after the PS sues the Prime Minister as soon as PM others, right? There's some information that's here. Also, you can be able to look at this information and do that. Guardians of the newspaper, the Nassau Guardian celebrated 179 years. This is the 179th anniversary. Yesterday, publisher Emmanuel Alexio, is pictured just cutting some cake. Make sure you pick up the newspaper. Grant makes statement to police over viral video. You got to look at that. And DeSantis again. Governor DeSantis, Florida's Governor DeSantis, take on this kind of a posture and position yet again and says that the U.S. would flatten the Bahamas if attacked Florida. This is bananas. We don't want to attack Florida. Where we can go to Walmart? It's crazy. Let's just be very clear. Obviously, he don't know the dynamics of our community. Walmart essential. Almost billions of dollars travel from the Bahamas to Florida annually. As island nations, we need more than just to be able to look pretty in the sunshine. We need things, things, things. Amen. Let's just be able to put it like that, guys. The line's going to be wide open today. I want you to kind of chime in with me. Let's make these things happen. I got to give a shout out to my good, decent friends over at AFS Agents, Insurance Agents and Brokers. They're going to be able to get your things straight for you. Number 407 Blue Hill Road, south. That's when you're heading down south. Right there on the left-hand side or east of the Golden Gate Shopping Plaza. They can be able to assist you and all those persons who got jitneys and taxis and whatnot. And you need yourself to find yourself in a position where you're going to need to stretch out this payment. You ain't got it right now. You ain't got the whole thing right now. You got to feed the children and get your bus on the road, get your taxi on the road. You can do that. They get in-house financing available for you. All you got to do is reach out to my good, decent friend, Ethric Bow, he'd be more than happy to assist you in getting those things taken care of, or he'll send you to his wife or his competent staff down there. Give him a call, 341-1AFS, 341-1AFS. They'd be more than happy to assist you in those areas. Guys, it is a beautiful day. It's a Friday. And I hope you're getting yourselves geared up for the weekend. Your sweet thing in the can, get her lashes on. Talk to me. She get her lashes on. And looking at you, batting her eyes, like the lady in the Tramp. You watch that? All she needs is a kiss now to seal this deal. Let's make this thing happen. Have a great weekend. I want to be able to take our first commercial break and be right back after this.
You're looking for a burger that is 100% flame-grilled beef and comes with all the fixings you love, nothing beats the classic Whopper from BK. So, how do you make this classic flame-grilled Whopper from Burger King better? You double it! With double the cheese and double the bacon, this sandwich can fill any appetite. Introducing the Double Whopper from Burger King that is so big and delicious that the only way to make it better is to make it a combo. Try the new Double Whopper at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. Buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Want to reach your Grand Bahama customers? Then call Barefoot Marketing at 827-4578 or message them for ad rates via their Facebook page. Advertising opportunities now include classified ads too. Keep up with all the latest Grand Bahama news in the Nassau Guardian newspaper every Tuesday.
Let me ask you a few questions. What's your name?
Pam.
Favorite food?
Steak.
Beer or wine?
Wine.
Is your money safe?
It's under my bed, I guess so.
Are you serious?
Yeah, why?
Unless your money is in a bank or credit union that's a member of the Deposit Insurance Corporation, there's no guarantee it's safe.
Yeah, but what if something happens to the bank?
Your Bahamian dollar deposits are insured up to $50,000, so you'd still be ahead. Plus, your mattress might catch fire. Then what?
Man, those banks and credit unions are looking good right about now.
Visit the DIC's website at www.dic.bs. Protection for your money, guaranteed with DIC.
Holiday Madness is going on now at BWF Wilton Street. Deals, 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 and more deals. Come save with us. Get up to 50% off during Black Friday pre-Christmas 6 days blowout sale event. For all you need and more this holiday season, shop BWF for super savings. doorbuster specials, lots of prizes, surprises, and giveaways Monday, November 20th through Saturday, November 25th, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Save big on Christmas supplies, junkanoo and craft supplies, appliance combo specials, barbecue grills, household, kitchen and outdoor cooking supplies, lawn and garden, hardware supplies, industrial and power tools, generators, compressors and pressure washers, and much more. BWF Black Friday pre-Christmas sale. Number 13 Wilton Street, telephone 394-0004 or 6. BWF, we are more than just our name.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
This is that ice cold Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Styling, wildin', living it up in the city. Got Chuck's on with Saint Laurent, gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot. Call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot. And my band bought that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio. Howard Grant in your company. It is all about the postmortem of the... Listen, there's a couple of things I want to talk with you today. I just want to be as clean and decent as possible as I do so and not lead into great speculation. First and foremost, yesterday I was adorned in my yellow. As a man of my word, I wore yellow as my teeth cringed because I don't want to adorn myself in no political party colors. I don't want to do this at all. But I'm a man of my word, I wore my yellow. And in absolute amazement, I didn't go to sleep Wednesday night until about 2:30 in the morning. Let me tell you what the amazement was. I got a couple of calls from some people in Polling Division number 14 is where my family votes. Polling Division number 14 actually was the poll where, let me look at these numbers, 485 people was registered in this polling division. Ricardo Grant captured 97 of those votes, right? Out of the 97, Kingsley got 111 votes and beat Ricardo Grant by 37, where... The COI's Lincoln Bean got 44 votes. All of this is bonkers to me. None of it makes sense based upon the course of tradition that exists in this space. I just want to be very clear with you. This election didn't go as I thought it would. Not necessarily for the political organizations, but for what exists on the ground. Now, I want to have this conversation with you and be very clear. This is not a smear campaign. Please, y'all, for God's sake. I don't know why y'all is do this. Y'all is cut. The fellas ready down on the ground. The wound wide open. There's no need for you to be not a good Samaritan. What are the regular Samaritans? Come there, throw salt in it, and then rub it. You need to stop it. There's no need for you to send invitations around for the conference for Bishop Ricardo Grant. They make up one conference. I don't even know what the thing called. They send it around. I look at it and say, my God, it's a behemoth. People, you all need to stop. I look at it and say, let the church say amen. I say, my God, why they do this? I'm looking at it. I say, this is indecent. Somebody else texts and things and say, I don't think his wife can stay home. Listen, y'all need to stop. This opportunity that we have here is only for clarity, for postmortem, political synopsis. For the purposes of clarity to understand where we are as we chart this road to 2026. As I look at Brave Davis, his posture, not in victory, his comfort. And we just remember 5 years ago, 4 years ago, 3 years ago. I want to say 5 years ago because it started then. It started with his speech. It started with that. Now, I'm not here to say somebody coaching him. And that's not what this is. I'm saying that he garnered confidence over the course of 5 years. We watched him. Over the last 5 years, I watched his posture, his confidence, his consistency, his ability to not... come on now. We're all of us right here. We're watching him all this time. We're looking at leadership. And he strengthened his posture and position, even climbing to the election 2021. His consistency. He's learned to be able to use that pattern, because he has a pattern the way that he speaks. Okay? The frequency in his voice, the rhythm of his voice, he used it to his advantage. If you listen to him, if you pick up on these things, if you listen to him, he has strengthened himself in this sort of a posture. And I looked at him when he was in Bimini and how he didn't stutter and no uncertain terms said every promise that was made to you. If you put Kingsley in, I will take care of it for you. In so many words. And I listen and I say, hold on, his body language is too calm. His posture is consistent. He's looking the crowd in their eyes. There is a sense of commitment. And I want to say to you that I believe him. I believe that he believes what he's saying. But I can't believe that he said that. Why would you say that? This is my mind. And I looked at this and I said to myself, if this continues, this may be the only, oh my God, should we say this too early? This is too early. This is too early. All right, we can hold this off. We're going to say this by the end of the first quarter of 2024, God spare our lives. By the end of the first quarter, 2024, God spare our lives, we're going to have a very clear conversation as to where the PLP is headed. Between now, that's 100 days. Let's give him 100 days. Between now and then, we're going to make an assessment on not only the performance of, because this is almost humanly impossible. The Prime Minister can't be in his constituency and everybody's constituency and all the focus on Kingsley Smith. He's not omnipresent. He can't do it, but he made that commitment. Now we have to see how West Grand Bahama would receive Kingsley and whether or not this is going to lead to a true sense of liberation, an opportunity for West Grand Bahamians. I'm indifferent with it, though. I'm indifferent. I don't believe it could happen. Am I pessimistic? I don't know if I'm pessimistic about it. I believe that Obi's proximity and access to power. You remember I wrote a speech? I don't think I ever read the speech. I'm going to read the speech one of these days. I'm going to get it and read it. I started to talk about how Obi has a global glow, how he's a globetrotter, how he's perpetually in the state of jet lag, how much he travels around the world, and how he would go off afar off and bring a zebra back to the PLP, or more specifically to Nassau, but wouldn't even bring a zebra leg to West Grand Bahama. This is when he was strategically in a position to assist West Grand Bahama and Bimini. I mean, save the projects that existed in Bimini with Bimini Bay. Save the projects that came to the forefront that he was able to cut the ribbon for and do those particular things. That we had to hold our breath to hope that Sunwing would come back. That we had to hold our breath to see if what's going to happen with Ginn. The only time we saw any movement. And the possibility that resurfaces and come to the forefront is when Obi is in office, Obi Wilchcombe, during that particular time. Now, the Prime Minister, I don't even know if he's appraised, if anybody appraised him on how much promises Obadiah Wilchcombe in his capacity as Member of Parliament sitting at strategic position in the country made to West Grand Bahama. My God, how are you going to do all that? We got to list this out. I don't even know if I have paper long enough. Because Obi made individual promises and commitments to families. And then he made an overarching commitment to the community. How? How is it that the Prime Minister could be able to live up to all of that? My God. I reached out to Kingsley Smith. I hit him up. Just give him a little congratulations, so forth and so on. And I said, "No, I'd like to talk with you when you get a chance." He said, "Well, Howard, not today." I said, "I know, I'm not going to fight you." I said, "But I'd like to talk with you on air. And I have one question I need to ask you. Did the representation of all the cabinet ministers put pressure on you for 2026? Because he led us in his sort of acceptance speech. And can I say that this was a horrible concession speech by the Free National Movement? It was absolutely horrible. You need to say, I concede. These are things that we need to hear. In his acceptance speech and sort of the victory speech, as he continues to be able to kind of wrap his mind around the fact that he has become the member of parliament after this significant push. He is now the member of parliament for West Grand Bahama and Bimini. I see him rubbing his forehead and saying, wow, man, all these cabinet ministers show up, man. Listen, I know I can be alone in 2026. That is humongous. That he is thinking sustainability. He's not only here for the quick ride, he's looking for longevity. And he recognizes that it was significant pressure on his shoulders as he leads, as going to be able to, you can't match that. Everybody else can be in their constituency. What's going to happen in 2026? I guess we'll cross that bridge when we get there. But I was impressed, man. I was impressed. I might as well tell you the truth. I was absolutely impressed with the PLP. I tell you all, nobody could campaign like PLP in this country. I was impressed with the PLP. I was impressed that they turn on the entire machinery of the organization. And though the former prime minister indicated that they get the country's purse, that they get the government's purse, and they're being able to utilize those particular things, I just want to say this. The intensity of their campaign remains consistent with the intensity of the campaign that we saw in 2021. I'm telling you the truth. This is what I see. Their campaign took a turn in 2017. The 2012 campaign, consistent. We believe in Bahamians. We believe. That was an amazing campaign. Y'all can't out-campaign the PLP. I might as well just tell you. Now, I started my entire thing off. I got to give you some preambles before I open up this line, because I see some people on there. And you can cuss me, but I got to put this out there, because you ain't going to tell me I didn't sue this. I started this off in saying, pound for pound, toe to toe, blow for blow, Kingsley Smith cannot take Bishop Ricardo Grant. I started off by that. I did say that. I said, but you know what is interesting? As this campaign intensifies every single day, I see more and more PLP legends hit the ground in West Grand Bahama and Bimini. Every single day. Watch me. And as I look at this, I say to myself, well, this is peculiar. I feel like you are rolling into, this ain't FNM votes now. I started off by telling you that because the FNM campaign paled in comparison to the PLPs. This was on the notion that we know the bishop. And when the information came back to us from the advance poll that the FNM may be up 3-1, my God, that day they turned on it. They put the fire. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was in the fire and the fourth man was missing. How am I preaching? The fourth man wasn't in the fire this time. And I believe that it was design and divine. This was melting season. I don't know if it was mental melting breakdown. I don't know what all these things. I know what I saw come out in the media. I cringed every single time. And I'm talking about traditional media in the paper. I ain't even talking about on social media. They like to take you to work, Bishop Ricardo Grant. And as I saw that, I said, oh my God. I started getting calls. I don't know. I started getting calls. Hold on, man. The bishop ain't do this for really. I said, you need to call him, and I don't know what you... Howard, the bishop, listen. If these were a fraction of the Inquisition that existed in West Grand Bahama and Bimini about whether or not they support a man from the pulpit, a man of the cloth, and these allegations levied against him so significantly, and there he has not even denied the allegations. God, Jesus. Lord, somebody need to, you all need to go to political school when you're trying to do this thing. He hasn't even denied the allegations. All he said, as I'm watching with great intent, I'm looking at Hubert Ingram. Hubert Ingram has a way he don't even know how to hide. He chew gum. Chew the whole speech. I say, my God, he trying to kill that gum. Because he don't want his facial expressions to show me that this man ain't know how to say this. He says he's a good talker. Yeah, right. He stood up there and said for 35 years, this my bishop, he was my bishop. I went to this man's church. I tell you, I learned to read the Bible from him. These are not new. Many of these allegations I've heard before. Going to his church, people said to me, Howard, I hear the bishop is do this, I hear the bishop is do that. This man is undeniable as it relates to being able to be a preacher. You cannot take that from him. The gift come without repentance. This man is absolutely undeniable when it comes to preaching. And then he stood behind this political pulpit. This ain't his pulpit no more. This political lectern. He stood behind this and said, for 35 years, they dragged my name through the mud and God keep blessing me. Sir, that's not denying. That's not being able to speak to the issues that exist for you. That's not going to help me as a voter choose you, especially when there is a significant reduction in those persons in the community and throughout the Bahamas that are leaving the church. These people ain't married, they ain't in church. You can't say this and expect it to be okay. I keep getting promoted and God keep blessing me. Well, if the voice of the people is the voice of God, what do we call this? Lines are open. 323-6232-325-4316, 325-4259, anywhere from the family of islands, 242-300-5720, or hit me up, 422-4796. Caller on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Mr. Grant.
Hey, how you doing? Thank you so much for holding.
The voice of the people is not the voice of God. That is not scripture. That's only what people say.
Okay.
But the people have spoken. That's who they want. They want the PLP.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like when people say how much percentage people went out to vote. A win is a win. The PLP.
Well, why you don't like when people say that?
No, because this one say, oh, 57% people went out. Where it was 30% people went out to vote, well, that's who just won't go out to ready to vote because it was free once and for all to go. Now, if the people decide not to go, because why? They didn't buy into what Lincoln Bay was saying, okay, about the school and the road. Now, these things were there not just 2 years ago. There was a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't buy into what Mr. Pendard was saying.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Pastor Grunt, he listened to what it looked to me now is like a culture. Most of these women now are prophesying to people and stuff like that, telling them the Lord said this. The Lord, he allowed those two women to prophesy to him, say, God, say, go ahead and run. Because I hear him in my own mouth say he had prayed to the Lord, and the Lord answered prayer, and he must go. See, it's a serious thing when we say the Lord say this, and we know God is not involved in these things.
What you mean? What you mean God ain't involved in these things? And he said that the government, it's no, rest upon his shoulder?
Listen to what I'm saying. If God didn't say it, that's what I'm saying. If God didn't say
it... Well, we know if God said it or not until the results come. And my God, November 22nd, we look and say, well, God couldn't have told him this.
That's what I'm saying. We know he didn't say it because it ain't happened.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Because when God says something, I don't care how it looks.
Is he an amen?
If amen, that mm-hmm. is going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But we know from Bible days, God is saying the false prophet went out and prophesied false in my name, and I didn't say it.
Mm.
So, the point is, Michael, Mr. Pintard, to all due respect, he got to go.
You wilding out. Down. You are wilding out. He says
he got to step down.
He says political position is secured.
Step down.
Free National Movement leader Michael Pintard does not think that the party lost in the West Grand Bahama and Bimini by-election will be a threat to his position. He ain't thinking. He's thinking straight.
They going to open the door for him and they going to push him out.
My God. We can see. Thank you, my brother. I do appreciate your telephone call, guys. The lines are wide open. Let me take the next telephone call before we get out of here. Call on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Hey. Pleasant. Good afternoon. How are you doing?
I'm good, man. What's happening with you?
Everything's good.
Anton, you need to stop. You need to go ahead, Anton. Anton, don't bring no salt on this radio today. We don't, you don't come to rub into the wound and finish.
Look here. Thank you, Howard.
Go ahead.
Before I said anything, I actually forgot to start out not only with congratulating yourself and Mrs. Grant on your two-decade anniversary, but also you had just announced that Chester's mom was also celebrating her anniversary.
Yes. She said her parents were celebrating the anniversary.
Oh, her
the same
parents.
Day.
Okay,
yes,
right.
Yes.
So I wanted to extend congratulations to Chester's grandparents celebrating their anniversary, right?
Yeah.
Right, Alan?
Yes.
Okay, so now.
Go ahead.
Back to the business of that.
Let me hit a bit.
Look here, Alan, let me ask you a question before I say anything.
Anton, these people say they hate you being happy. Go ahead.
You are an honest man. Let me ask you a question.
I can be truthful. Let's go.
Yeah, thank you. Based upon the leader of the opposition, Michael Pintard, who led the FNM into war against the Honorable Philip Brave Davis, Prime Minister of this country, 2021, 2026, 2031, etc.
You
right?
want to note, sir.
Like, yeah.
You want to note.
Considering that they lost ground in FNM staunch FNM polling division
you
in
know?
That by-election, what do you think that says about Pintard's leadership?
I thought about this, Anton.
Yes.
I did. I don't.
And then I can make my point off your response, please.
The very first call that I got when Obi died, the very first call I got was, we don't believe that the Free National, this is from FNM strongholds.
Right.
Okay? From people who have voted FNM their entire life.
Right.
We don't believe that the Free National Movement should contend in this one. Let the PLP take this. This one for Obi. This is a sympathy vote. That's the very first call. I get six calls like that.
Mm-hmm.
Six calls. Mm-hmm. And then I had an in-depth conversation with my father. And
right.
I said to him, he said, what do you think? I said, I can tell you this. This is before we read the paper with Hubert Ingram. I said, I don't think Hubert Ingram would run anybody in this constituency. And then that day, the paper says, Hubert Ingram released information to Pintard, which released in the council, and the council leaked it out to the Tribune, right? And I said to him, I called my own man, and I said, listen, I told you that. I said, Hubert Ingram come from a different cloth, it come from a different elk, and this is a little small battle. You don't bother with battles. You go for the big hog. You won the hog in 2026. Keep canvassing the ground and deal with what you got to deal with. I said, as much as the promises to West Grand Bahama and Bimini, don't get in that. If the PLP can do something, let them do it. If they can do something, don't bother. Michael Pintard went contrary to that. He said them, right? And we heard the former prime minister indicate, hey, listen to me. I'm only a member. I only got one vote. I got an opinion, but I got one vote. And we saw what happened. Polling division 5 and 6, he lost. Polling division 14, he lost. He won polling division 12. By 2.
My gosh.
He won polling division 11A by 4.
My gosh.
This blow my mind. This blow my mind. Now, I can say this.
That's
if the sentiments come from West Grand Bahama,
to answer the question.
This is for West Grand Bahama.
Mm.
This one for Obi. Pintar didn't read the leash right.
Mm.
In my personal view, I don't think that that's anything to do with his leadership. I think that that's his sort of a youthful, zealous approach to be able to ensure that he defends the party with its honor, so forth and so on. Okay.
Listen,
Antoine, let me be decent.
Yes,
he is brand new in his posture and position. Externally, as an observer, think he should not have done it. I think he went contrary.
Well, yesterday, remember, you did say, man, Bishop should have stayed and changed.
He should have stayed. He shouldn't have bothered. He should not have bothered with this. Bishop was on the ground, some people say, anywhere from 6 to 15 months just touching people.
Right.
And after all that time, the very first interview, the bishop say, I'm only listening to people. And then when the Free National Movement came, they gave him talking points. This was not for him.
Right.
And you can't bring Jesus in this.
Now, let me give you my summation, Howard, right? Even while Obi was alive, right, and the people could feel him, the people could look in his eyes, the people could touch him, those polling divisions were still F&M stronghold.
100%.
1,000%, Howard.
Okay, talk to me.
And so, Howard, when you look at what God really said in that election, Kingsley Smith increased the margin of victory, right? Right, Howard?
Somebody say Kingsley Amen this. This one for Obi.
Listen here.
Go ahead.
All of that was in the court.
Go ahead, I can fight you.
But the bottom line is Kingsley Smith is the candidate and he is the member of parliament today, right?
Mm-hmm.
He increased his margin of victory, right? The F&M lost. They lost further with their margin of defeat, right, Howard?
Mm-hmm.
Over that of Pekisha Parker.
Mm-hmm.
Who lost the seat?
Patricia Parker was able to keep.
But she still held on to those F&M strongholds.
She held the F&M strongholds. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Howard.
Yeah.
And so I say all of that just to make the point, Howard. I think the most damning stab to the heart for Pintard, the leader of the opposition, and the F&M, and all those who supported him and mounted the stage, was the fact that they couldn't even hold on to the F&M strongholds. The staunch F&Ms even ran against them. So what does that say to me about the F&Ms leadership? They have lost confidence, my brother. They have lost confidence.
So what's your expectation? What's your expectation going forward?
I can tell you that right now. No, let me just end this in 10 seconds, and then I can tell you that.
Okay, go ahead.
Howard, those staunch F&Ms, even those staunch F&Ms who stand up with the F&Ms, even in defeat, they have lost confidence in their leader, who's at the helm. That's what that tells me. Anybody can come behind and try and spin it any other way, but the facts are very clear, and the numbers don't lie, my brother. The numbers don't lie. Now, what was that last question you asked me, please, Howard?
What do you think it stands now with Pintard? Because this post-mortem, the bishop really lose. He got to go back to the church hat in hand, and hopefully they could be able to accept him, and because he started ground zero again in the community. Right?
What does it mean for Pintard?
What does it mean for Pintard going forward?
That's an excellent question. What does it mean for Pintard? In my view, based on the Prime Minister stepping in the ring and making the commitment, based on Obi's political partner, foot for foot, step for step, stepping in the ring, going on down there in Grand Bahama and campaigning, Glenys Anna Martin, the Honorable, based on the cabinet. Let me tell you something, Albert. When the Prime Minister keeps his word and does all that we promised for the people of
West
Bahama and Germany,
why you say
what
if?
Do you think is going to happen?
You say when. Why you say if?
No. You know if and about this. The Prime Minister is the man who keeps his word. I'm saying to you, when he keeps his word and does what he says he is going to do and backing Kingsley Smith Jr. and executing on all the good promises that are necessary for the upliftment of those constituents in West Grand Bahama and Germany, what do you think is going to happen?
The only thing I can see happening, Anton, and I got to let you go, is it's getting from glory to glory.
Glory to glory!
You need to stop.
2026?
Stop it. Anton, you're not going to campaign on my radio. You need to stop. But I said, we're not going to have that conversation till the first quarter. I'm going to give you 100 days. I got to be decent. I'm going to give you 100 days between now and the end of the very first quarter of 2024, God spare our life, to make an assessment on whether or not we see the PLP moving towards victory in 2026. This defeat And West Grand Bahama speaks with clarity to the leadership style, posture, and position of the Prime Minister, Brave Davis, who have strengthened himself significantly, and what we've seen in defeat. You see, because sometimes you can't tell a man's character, his posture, his position, his tenacity, his determination to be relentless in moving forward unless and until there is defeat. And in defeat, the posture of the leadership of the Free National Movement is a little bit shaky. Quick commercial break and be right back after this.
The Foundation. We'll be back right after this. The Foundation. Guardian Radio and The Foundation are on the move.
Bahamas, this one's for you.
SBT. Small Business Thursdays. Every Thursday, The Foundation with Howard Grant will highlight small businesses throughout the country, far and wide. Your products, services, prices, and personality. We want to hear it all. Get your 30 or 60 second advertisement heard on air at a fraction of the cost. We here at The Foundation understand the times and don't want you to be left behind. With Guardian Radio, you reach your specific demographic, and it is unmatched.
We reach thousands daily.
Get your products off the shelf and your services in their hearts. Small Business Thursdays with The Foundation, only on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. For more information, call 302-2300 or the Help Me Howard line at 827-0111. SBT. Small Business Thursdays. Get your business moving today.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
Tonight's big matchup with Infection United is about to start. Kate has possession of the flu. She coughs up a pass across to Steve, who gives it to William. William is causing headaches on the field. He spreads it to Rachel, who scores! A hospital bed.
Don't play with respiratory infections like influenza or COVID-19. They can lead to hospitalization and even death. Advise patients to keep a safe distance, practice good hygiene, and get vaccinated. Don't play with their health.
This message is brought to you by the Ministry of Health and Wellness, PAHO, WHO, and the Canadian government.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Foundation. The Foundation.
Somebody takes me and say, Howard, based on that kind of a rationale, did the people vote against God by electing Kingsley? This is bananas. I won't be able to introduce. Yeah, Garth is here with me. Garth, just say hey to the people. You just walk in.
You're reading this text.
I got to be able to read these texts because
read the
it's
text,
coming
man.
Through.
Read the text.
This is coming through. Somebody text me and I won't read this, you know. I won't read this.
I want you to read it.
I got
to
read this like this, right? It says, Howard, Motormouth Pintard won his seat by 57% of the votes with 66% of voter turnout. So why is he crying and being so hypocritical? No grace, just narcissistic. This is literally a text that's coming through. Now, we said this. Many times you can't judge a man's character, his posture, his position, the way that he or she is anchored in their conviction by their victories. Because victories can be a facade. We can always be able to, the exuberance, the excitement that exists in our spirit, the anticipation for tomorrow always bubbles to the surface. Thank you, everybody, for voting for us. You got champagne on your head. But the way that a man handles his defeat, his poise, his character, his grace, his humility, his determination, the ability to be able to rally the troops and rally those that supported him. He got a significant amount of support 20-some% for Bishop Ricardo Grant based upon the persons who voted for him. How do we retain that? Do we retain that with this sort of rejection and focusing on a nasty campaign run by the PLP, supposedly? Or are you focused on being able to identify those that supported you and remind them that we're coming back? Let's have a very clear conversation about this. You identify character in defeat. When Carl Kalmer cut my behind, I was walking into that. I knew that. The very first thing I said is, I remain committed to the organization, and I'm thankful for the opportunity and all those 18 persons who voted for me. Thank you. I know that we're going to expand that, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, because yeah, I learned from the best. I know how to do this.
You sound like Lincoln Benn.
Who, me?
That's what he said.
Well, he must have studied me.
He studied
because that's what I said when I lost to Carl Kalmer. Right? I just say that in jest, right? That's what I said when I lost to Carl Kalmer. You understand? See, the very next day I called Carl Kalmer. I called him for 3 months straight. I said, let me help you write this. Let me help you write that. Let me do this for you. Let me do that for you. And rejection didn't come on my part. I was locked out from the city.
Well, Howard, I would say good afternoon to the listeners, the Maine people, those who stopped me.
It's 1 o'clock, you know.
They stopped me. We're going to the news, but they stopped me. They talking Howard Grant. They talking the foundation. And I'm trying to excuse myself. And they having a conversation. Now they're taking a conversation from West Grand Mama Bimney all the way back down to Mike Hall, talking with Shane Gibson and all type of other stuff. And I'm like, hold a minute, man. This ain't the show, though. I got to get dressed and get to the show.
Well, let's do that. Let's get into it. Let's dive into these things, guys. We got to go to news. We got to go to commercial at 1 o'clock. We can do our best to chop these things down. Sparky, this you can be the first one out the gate when we come back, when we have this kind of a conversation. Guys, quick commercial break and be right back after news.
The foundation. The foundation. The foundation. Foundation.
foundation. The foundation. The foundation. The foundation. The foundation. The foundation. Foundation. The foundation.
Season is upon us, and everyone's going to be looking for those special items on their gift list. Merchants, here's your opportunity to have your products placed in the Nassau Guardian's holiday gift guide. This year, shoppers are going to be searching for perfect presents at the right price. Anything from a family island weekend getaway to electronics, jewelry, and even clothes. For one low price, you can have your ads published twice this December in the Nassau Guardian's Holiday Gift Guide. Deadline for registration is Wednesday, November 30th. Be sure to contact your Nassau Guardian sales agent or call the Nassau Guardian directly at 302-2300. Be sure to ask about our 15-30-second Christmas radio commercial bonanza.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
The Nassau Guardian's Holiday Gift Guide. Our gift to you. Because Christmas...
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Every day, countless Bahamians fall asleep hungry. But by working together, we can change this.
AML has committed $20,000 to provide nutritious meals for those in need during the holiday season.
As the holidays approach, help spread love and hope by supporting AML's 8th annual Feed 5,000 program.
Donate today at any Solomon's, Fresh Market, Crossright, Exuma Market, and Domino's Pizza.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Foundation. Foundation. The foundation. The foundation. 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 The foundation. The foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant in your company, The Foundation, right here on this beautiful Friday afternoon, live and in full effect. Black Friday. Black Friday. For all those persons in the United States of America, I don't know if you got your headphones on, standing in those long lines to get gink and push and shove, so forth and so on. I hope you got all your battle gear on to be able to get those televisions for $250, $260, so forth and so on. Listen, man, do your thing. I'm not going to fight you. Have a good time over there. Be safe when you're coming over, coming back. Make sure you check out your click to clear and everything like that with customs when you're doing those things. The one thing I love about y'all Bahamian people now, y'all going to travel. Y'all are going to travel, baby. We can get a little chance. That's a beauty. And the strength of our passport. We're going to have a good conversation. Guys, I'm here with none other than Garth Roseborough, just trying to kind of do a postmortem of what's happened on Wednesday night. Listen, I've been going up and down through these numbers. And I just want to look at the numbers. the external aspects and the concept and idea that has to do with faith and Christianity and this and that and all these things like that. Did they go against God? Blah, blah. I don't know. I see they all got Jasmine Darius up and Quincy Sayers up and down. You're dragging them through the mud. And I think the other prophet y'all got dragging up and down, I think, is it Yvette Sanders also? This is on the Facebook things. Mm-hmm. Y'all are wilding out. This thing is done. It is done. Kingsley probably right now by the tailor trying to get his scissors tailed suit, getting himself prepared. It is done, baby. Mm-hmm. You ain't got to drag the people no more. Let me take a telephone call. I know you guys have been waiting. Call on the line with this live. Go ahead.
Hey, good afternoon, Howard. And what's his name?
Garth. Yeah.
Okay. I would say this to you, Howard.
Mm-hmm.
Mrs. Smith worked his butt off down there in Grand Bahama.
I agree with you.
I was down there with him. Mm-hmm. And I could tell you this for far.
Mm-hmm.
Some is only took rejection from. But guess what? He sat there and listened to what they had to say. He sucked it in as a man. And he told them what his plans is to make it better for West Grand Bahama and Bimini. Okay? And those people bought into it. And I'll tell you this too. The difference between Kingsley and Ricardo Grant. All right. Kingsley could appeal to disgruntled FNMs, the youth, and PLPs, okay? Ricardo Grant only can appeal to the FNMs.
You got an echo in the back there. It's
yeah,
really, yeah.
I said I must be too close.
Yeah, come from the speaker or something like that.
Yeah, I must be too close.
To yeah, go ahead.
Can you hear me now?
Go ahead.
All right. And like I said, the difference...
Ricardo could only... He only could cater to who?
Pardon
me? You say Ricardo Grant could only cater to who? Church people?
To F&M's. Not even the church people, because right now, before I left Grand Bahama yesterday, they were saying that the church is waiting for him to come back to the church so they can deal with him also. No, for real.
Jesus, what are you on to do? You're trying to kill the man?
No,
let the man live. Oh, God.
Saying.
You want to kill him?
Because what happened is, whatever happened with that particular alleged scheme, the Ujamaa scheme, is not came back to haunt him. And what he should have done when that came up, just speak the truth. Just say, yes, I was a part of it and whatever happened, and no. I intend to do whatever I intend to do.
Well, he didn't do so, that.
It's easy to say sorry, you know.
Well, you got to be able to admit your participation, and if there is any guilt, you got to be able to. When you get in public life, it's different. It's just different. You have to be transparent. People are making a decision on your character. I ain't got nothing else to choose on. I got to choose on if some people are, you know, they got a background of economy, of economics, and understanding financial aspects. You got to be transparent in that way. Oh, wow, he takes care of his areas like this. Boom. Some people make a determination on family and whether or not you've been able to take care of your family. They make the decision like that. Some people look at your faith and your conviction. They make the decision like that. Some people look at your word. These people, we have to use every single element provided to us socially to determine whether or not we want you as our representative, especially if your participation has been few and far between in the community. Representation in the community in terms of a voice in the church is different from being in the community. I'll give you an example. Lawrence Roll, if he run in Fort Street to Grove right now.
Second Street to Grove.
Mm-hmm. Lawrence Roll, my good friend. If he run in there right now for the amount of poor people that he's been feeding over the years, if they register to vote for him, I'm not saying that he will win. But I'm saying to you, they will never deny him. He has been in the community, he's touched those people. Bishop Hanschel, he has been in the community, he's fed those people. Both preachers. But there are preachers in the vicinity, in the area, that only operate from their pulpit. And we may not even know their names. Yeah. You won't have the same effect. You have to be a participant in the community. No matter what people say but Lawrence Roll, you'll have 150,000 people right now ready to fight you. You got to be stupid, boy, not my bishop.
You're talking crap. You put him on the wrong ticket. Put him on the other ticket then and see what happens.
I'm not talking about ticket. I'm just talking about support in the community.
I'm talking about Jesus now. Who fed 5,000? Who raised the dead?
and they say
who healed the leper, turned water into wine. I mean, Jesus came and gave them a whole barroom.
My God,
they had Stoli and everything else, the best.
They only had wine. Stop it.
Their top shelf, whatever you want to say.
Yeah, it was
the best party they ever had.
It was the good one, you know.
Okay then.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, you give us Barabbas. There's something very strange about the Bahamian people. And what I like about you, Howard, we had a discussion off the air. What is it that the Bahamian people really want? If you ask the average voter in Bimini and Grand Bahama, and you know all of us here in Nassau are very interested in this by-election, but ask us really and truly, what is the Bahamian registered voter really wanting?
What do you think that is?
I gave my answer 2 days ago, but y'all see it different.
Money?
Things.
Things don't last, sir.
I understand these things, Howard, but I'm just saying to you, we cannot build a nation based on this philosophy. That's all I'm simply saying to you.
Yeah, but see, if you keep...
We've been going around in a circle for 50 years, sir.
Watch me.
50 years. We've been doing this. 50 years.
Watch me.
I'm listening.
If we take our posture and position...
Yes.
...and continue to be able to amplify, agitate,
yes,
and fortify a position of superficiality,
yes,
we ain't getting nowhere. We are participants in this merry-go-round.
I understand.
If we, with clarity, yes, sit here,
I agree,
in this posture,
I agree,
speaking to tens of thousands of people,
yes,
both locally and internationally, about our responsibility for a very clear detour that we see, we have to amplify that detour. And that detour is education. That detour is understanding the wherewithal that exists within you to make a decision to change.
I agree.
307 people decided to go contrary.
So you
to use the status quo.
You use a key word for me, Howard. Let's talk about this word education that you keep running to. We now have a governmental education system that's next to free, very minimal cost for a child to be enrolled in our schools. Tell me how that education process is now working in that Howard Grant sits here on a foundation and off the air, you and I had a discussion that we will not participate in just mere entertainment. We want to provide a very clear path of what leadership should look like and how this country needs that change but also can accomplish that change. Right now we're looking at our education system. You talk about education. You're using a word that I've heard some political people say, you don't need education to go to parliament. You don't need education to go to House Assembly. You don't need education, so what do you need? This is what I'm asking. You're saying it's education. They're saying they don't need that. And I'm saying to you, Howard Grant, you cannot force individuals to basically receive the understanding that what you desire is a better country that they should have.
It don't take 100% of the voters. Watch me. 62.75% of the voters voted out of 6,000 some people.
What did they vote for?
Whatever they voted for. Let's just everyone get a point here. 62% of the voters came out and voted and changed the course of history for West Grand Bahama and Bimini. They changed it. They chose Kingsley with an expectation that these things would happen. I don't care what are the variables that exist around that. Let's be very clear. It doesn't take the entire community, the some 400,000 Bahamians, to make a determination of a course that we need. It just take the few. Many are called, few are chosen. It just take the chosen to stand with conviction, unified, and speak with one language for change, growth, and development. That position and posture cannot vary from one conversation to another. It has to remain consistent. No matter how uncomfortable the thing is, Garth, it's uncomfortable.
But it's you. I hear you all through that. And I keep saying how the country is not you. Guess what's coming next? Hold on. Give me a break here. We just had Thanksgiving. I was on Gladstone Road. God knows, Howard Grant, I was on Gladstone Road. Listen to me, my Bahamian people. When we drive on this road, Howard Grant, the little cube and the little swift and the little note and these things zipping and zipping. Bahamian people, they have somewhere to go. I don't know where they got to go. So 21 miles by 7 in the middle of the day, but they zipping and zagging and zipping and zagging. And all of a sudden, I too was on the line. I'm going to confess my sins here today. And I'm in the middle of Gladstone Road, and there's a preschool. I'm not going to call the name, but they were there giving out free turkeys. And I said, well, so that's what this traffic jam is all about? And they said, yeah, man, come get a free turkey. So I said, man, let me see how this works. I would gladly get my free turkey too.
You got one?
What do you mean if I get my free turkey? But I just want to show you. The average baby got something to do, and then all of a sudden be distracted because it's free. Whatever we can get today right now is free. Right now, Christmas is coming, and all the promises what the Prime Minister gave just a while ago, ask the average voter to remember half of them. Ask them in January.
You keep,
ask them, because guess what? It is the promise that's the education, you know. The education for these people that you just said that they bought into was the promises. So I want to know, since that educated you, like when I went to school and I got a master's degree, I got two master's degrees, ask Garth Maynard Roseborough if he remembers half of what he learned in the classroom. And I'll tell you no. What I learned, though, is how to apply the knowledge that I have in circumstances and situations. But can the average Bahamian do that? For us to get from the nation that we are now to the Rwandas and to where people are over in the Philippines and over in Africa, for us to make the transition, Howard Grant, we may not be able to retain everything in our own minds, in our own spirit, in our own soul, but we got to be able to transform that ability to learn and to apply in order to get to the next level.
I just drew a Venn diagram on my paper.
You got to explain it to the people.
Okay.
I keep telling you these things.
That's okay.
My friend, but I can tell you these things. Okay. Go ahead.
This may go over some people's head, and I'm good with that.
Why?
Because whilst this is a show that is a show, we entertain, but we have a responsibility to educate. And the education may not be permeable for every single person, but there are persons out there that are listening who need to cut on a light in their spirit to change this country. They are in strategic positions. There are permanent secretaries that are listening to us. There are directors that are listening to us. There are comptrollers that are listening to us. There are police officers that are listening to us. There are doctors. There are lawyers in this country right now that have a mindset that it is what it is, but my God, don't we have to change this country. We have to change this country. There's a Venn diagram that I drew in front of me.
Go ahead.
This is who I talk and do. If you don't understand what a Venn diagram is, I don't have the time right now. Type in Venn diagram on Google. One circle within my Venn diagram is for the general populace. Okay?
Listening.
The next circle in the Venn diagram is for the 1%, is educated. There is an intersection between the educated and the general populace that represents the 5%ers, the 20% of our populace, who understand where they come from, but have a desire, if you want to call it the middle class, whoever you want to call that, a desire to be able to move with progression. They've seen some things. They know some things. And they know that all of us don't need to be in poverty the way that we are. They know that. Our proximity, our position, our education, and our faith says that all of us who suffer and endure poverty should not be there. And we can do better than this if we unify ourselves. That's where I am. I'm not here to have a conversation about a dude who needs a turkey. I'm not here for that. If I get the money to be able to get the turkeys, I will give that out. Mm-hmm. But the conversation is about reform for a community. We cannot allow money to make a determination as to whether or not we put one candidate in or not, and this candidate does not have the wherewithal to change the community. Then we're right back at cycle one. We're right back at ground zero again. The conversation cannot always be about money, and it's a very frustrating thing. That if you don't have conviction to be able to make a change for growth and development, if you don't have conviction to identify and attach yourself to the Constitution for growth and development, to add to contribute to a conversation for white people to change your stuff, to change your community, then what are we talking about?
Well, Howard, you do understand that it is this very same frustration that caused you to get up, put your name on a ballot, run, and take the cut that you took.
And there are more Howard Grants out there.
Well, I was one of them too. I did the same thing, Howard Grant. Did I not? Did I not become frustrated as well and do the same thing? But there are others like us who are watching us who say, you know what? Why would I want to do that to myself? And that is where we have issues in this country.
Do what to yourself?
Enter into this political fight and try to lift the country to a higher socioeconomic level.
But why not?
Because as far as they're concerned, they're better off just staying home and watching the show.
All of us can die the same way. Whether or not you're going to be in somebody's urn, or whether or not you're going to look at somebody tongue and groove at the top of their church roof, all of us going to be dead one day. When your name is counted and called in the annals of history, what the hell did you do? Now, That's all that matters. If you only come in here to be a burden on the government, to be a burden on the social system, to join a long line, to pick up a piece of chicken and row, but by God, why they giving us these healthy food? They might as well give me a tuna. Then this ain't for you. We can take care of y'all eventually. But this is for those who seek to reform this country. My God, God, that just get me so hot today.
Because, Howard, a couple of weeks ago, I had a conversation on your show. And I was very solemn. And I was telling you, Howard, I know one day I can die. And we had this on the mic. We had this conversation on the mic. And on the break, you said to me, Garth, you okay? You ain't leaving us, sir.
Yeah, but what you doing?
Because what I was saying to you is, Howard, is that this mortality that I have, I now understand that one day I will not be here. And I'm trying to say to everybody, wake up. One day we will not be here. But can we leave our country in a better place? Is it not worth the fight? And here you are fighting, Howard Grant. I'm saying to you, I'm asking you, why isn't it really that other people would join this fight? They're sitting there. 15% of them are sitting there that have the ability to do so, but they'd rather sit down home and watch.
What are you scared of?
Ask them.
I'm asking you.
Yeah, I've been there. I've been in this fight.
I'm not asking you.
I'm not afraid of anything.
What are you afraid of?
I'm not afraid of anything.
Okay. This is a text that's coming through. It says, Howard, you cannot be that naive.
See?
It's a text.
I listen to that text.
And I'm going to read a contrary text also. There's a percentage of people out there.
Please.
Let's just read this. It says, Howard, you cannot be that naive. Your guest is telling you what is, and you are busy speaking about what you think it ought to be. Those are two distinctively different things. Your guest clearly understands the big picture and the Bahamian voters. His assessment is spot on. This is a text that's coming through.
Thank you.
Okay. We're not going to fight that.
We ain't fighting.
Okay. What is your responsibility? What do you see when you look at a blank piece of paper? What do you see?
Who, me?
Yeah.
I see a blank piece of paper.
That's all you see.
That's what I want to see.
Okay, so what do you design on that paper? Do you write, do you draw what exists, or do you draw what you envision?
I always draw what I envision.
Okay.
I run my
show. What your vision, does it line up with what exists?
Not all the time.
You have aspirations for greater.
Of course.
You have ideas for growth.
Of course.
If you continue to be able to speak of that which is and not speak with an idea that it could be more, then what are we doing? That's all I ask it. What are we doing?
Howard.
That's all I ask it.
Listen to me.
I am not a robot. I am not designed to come here and live a mediocre life and only just be able to push papers and shovel and do the exact same thing and leave my children with debt. And praise Jesus for service lot of $15,000 and say, my God, I'm so happy that the government gave me this government house. Oh, my God. And as I die with my last breath, I say, oh, we'll try to sell the truck before I go so you can pay the bills. You think that's what we called for?
Here's what it is, Howard. This is how I, being the CEO of Goldstream Arms Limited for some time, and, you know, of course, we are in our struggle as well. 5%, as we understand it, of this country is extremely well off. 15% in this country are the people that manage the wealth of the wealthy. That's how I look at it. You manage the wealth of the wealthy. You don't have any wealth of your real, of yourself. Your wealth is based on someone else's wealth or your earnings. 80% of our people are what we call the masses. They're the ones who are, for lack of better terminology, they're fighting for crumbs. Every day. Every day is a fight for, I need a job, I got to pay my bills, I don't have enough money in my bank account. The problem with the 15%, like people like ourselves, Howard, is that somehow the 80% finds us. The wealthy people don't have to worry about that 80% because the job of the 15% is to protect the wealthy from the 80%. But the money of the wealthy actually comes from the pockets of the masses. The 80%. That's how wealthy people live. They get their money from... Hold on. I'm just trying to show you a management system, Howard. It's managed. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I hear your idealism. I want 80% to be the 5%. I would like 80% of the people to be wealthy. I would like that in my own mind. I would even like some of those 80% of the people to be the 15%. But the management of this, the management of this for the last 50 years has been 5, 15, and 80.
I am willing to die on this hill. Prostrate. and let my carcass lead from one side to another and slide down into oblivion. I am willing to die. Die!
When did you have this epiphany?
Sir,
when did you have
all my life I carry this.
So let me ask you a question.
All my life I knew that I was called for something bigger.
So you have a passion.
I do everything. Hold on, Garth. Let me deal with this, please. I do every single thing I can to ensure that I can leave a legacy for my children's children. That I can be able to, and this thing had nothing to do with no faith. Before I learned to read the Bible, I know that there was something different about me. Before I learned to read the Bible, I could give you stories of how I assessed my friends in the third grade. I could give you stories of how I assessed my family in second grade. Whilst I was laying down there with my leg broken under someone's car. In the second grade, I knew that we were called for more than this. Excuse me, let me just be very clear with you, because there are comrades of mine that exist in here. I'm not going to allow you to sit here and condescending to a people who need hope. They already exist. There is enough for talk shows all over the world and all over the place for you to be able to go, but every just to ingest information like this. You can ingest it anywhere. That's pessimism that exists out there. But who is going to speak with optimism, with an idea that there is an opportunity beyond what exists?
But Howard,
who's going
to
do that?
But Howard, I'm saying to you, listen to what I'm saying to you. I gave you the story of my mother just the other day. You don't have to be in any one of those categories. You can choose
which category. But you don't get to tell me where my conviction stands.
No one is saying that to you. What we're saying to you, Howard, is that everyone doesn't see things the way you do.
And that's okay.
You are unique.
Okay.
You are unique.
That's okay.
Okay, then.
The desire is not for everyone to be like me. The desire is to identify those persons who have the same spirit, and we could unify to change the majority. That's it. That's what political parties are.
I want to hear that word, unify.
Everybody don't believe in the unify PLP. There. Everybody don't believe in the PLP. Everybody don't believe in the FLM.
I agree.
Everybody don't believe in the COI.
I agree.
Everybody don't believe in the DNA. But all you need to do is identify comrades for your cause. And you push forward for your cause. That's all you do.
I agree.
And this is my cause. This will have no political stand in front of it.
Howard, I sit as one of the leaders of a very same group that has the same philosophy. Unified. I do the same thing. But I'm saying to you, Howard, what I'm learning, though, is that I'm trying to tell the listening audience, here you are sacrificing to educate in this very same philosophy.
I don't think that's a sacrifice.
You don't think it's a sacrifice?
Listen to me. I want more for myself and my family. I do. I can tell you the times I've tried to move off to the States, to Canada, to Turks and Caicos, to all over. I could tell you all these stories.
Mm-hmm.
How every single time I was rejected. And the only time that I've ever been able to move from Grand Bahama is when the doors open up in Nassau for me. That's it. I don't know how you want to read that, but I've never been able to move anywhere. Anywhere. And the only place I was ever welcome is in Nassau, Bahamas.
For such a time as this.
Now you won't get preachy with me after you didn't hit me. You didn't drown me with pessimism. You didn't stop me with pessimism. You dragged me through the hole.
Life is
with your
not,
relentless pessimism.
Life is not stagnant.
Now you won't tell me for such a time as this. Okay, Esther, Monica, you need to stop. Quick commercial break and be right back after this.
The Foundation. We'll be back right after this. The Foundation.
At Marco's Pizza, try the Pepperoni Magnifico, Sausage Magnifico, or the Ultimate Magnifico Pizzas, starting at $18.50. The new bold Magnifico Pizzas are loaded with your choice of either Old World Sausage or Pepperoni and traditional Pepperoni or Sausage, topped with Roma San seasoning, made with Marco's original sauce and three cheeses. Order the new Magnifico Pizzas on Marco's Pizza Bahamas app or online. Available for a limited time.
They coming! Dream deals this weekend at Alive. Shop Black Friday, Switch Saturday, or Cyber Monday, and get your holiday season started right. Skip the rush this Christmas with the gifts your loved ones are dreaming of. Get up to 85% off devices and major discounts when you switch to Alive. Join the Bahamas' fastest network. Junkanoo is Alive.
You've tried everything. ASUS with your mother's cousin's sister's auntie, and even hiding your money under your mattress. But is your money safe? Your Bahamian dollar deposit in a member bank or credit union is insured up to $50,000. If anything happens, your deposit up to the insured value will be returned to you thanks to Deposit Insurance. Visit Deposit Insurance Corporation at www.dic.bf.
Protection for your money guaranteed with DIC.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, quality.
Foundation. The foundation. Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio. Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation, live and in full effect on this Friday. Garth is trying to ruffle my feathers in here by being able to drag this relentless bag of stinky pessimism. I just don't want it. Oh, Garth, I won't be decent. Yeah, let me tell you why.
It brings the best out of you, Howard.
Let me tell you why. I could be naive. I could be whatever. It don't matter. I refuse to be an average Joe. I refuse to be Joe Public. I will stand firm and convicted in my position as Howard Grant. And if I die with nothing at all, and I'm unable to leave anything to my children, I left them with the conviction that we can do better. We can. And I believe that. Dr. Clifford Smith yesterday, who joined me, said he's listened to me for the longest time. Right? And he wanted to be able to commit himself to assisting with whatever we can in terms of being able to build this. There are some people that I just need to be able to connect with. And I promise you, if I connect with the right people, both locally and internationally, because this is not just a fight that's happening locally, we can open up some minds. 400,000 Negroes is not a lot. 400,000 people is not people. A lot, sir.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a lot. I might as well tell you that. That's nothing. That's nothing to talk about. That's a casual conversation on a Tuesday afternoon. All you need is discipline, structure, vision. And we can execute this.
And you expect this to come from the leaders, yes?
I don't expect nothing from leadership. That's why I'm sitting here having this conversation. I expect them. When we had a conversation what existed in West Grand Bahama and Bimini, we talked about the tradition of politics. We talked about the rhythm that existed prior. I expected to see that rhythm. This threw me off. And I don't know whether or not this is as a result. And you remember we talked about this? I said pound for pound, toe to toe, blow for blow, Kingsley Smith can't take Ricardo Grant. We didn't see one. Well, let's just be clear about this. Let's be honest about this. We didn't see one infraction. No murmurs, nothing popping up in the public, nothing on social media about Ricardo Grant until the advance poll. And they say, oh my God, let's turn this up. Boom. I do not fight the PLP or sub-organizations for doing what they did. We in this to win. And whatever it takes to win, baby, let's win. Sometimes it takes money, sometimes it takes a reminder, whatever it takes to win, we here to win. But if you go back to my very first story about when Ricardo Grant was officially introduced to this, I said he shouldn't do this. I said that. I remain steadfast in that. People bring godliness and all this. Listen, this is only Bahamian politics. We know the tradition. We know the rhythm that exists. And there was no expectation that that information was going to come to the forefront. He lost. And I'm hoping that he didn't lose everything. Because this sometimes is unforgiving.
What did we win as a nation? Mr. Howard Grant. You said he lost. He's a preacher by...
profession.
Professional calling, whichever way he would like to have it. I would hope that he would continue to educate and be involved in the community. And by Mr. Smith winning, what have we as a people won? And what would have been the educational benefit in the entire process?
We only win the pause of observation. That's it. We only win the pause of observation. We now are poised to continue to look at West Grand Bahama and to see if the promises that were made to West Grand Bahamians will come to the forefront, if the Prime Minister will commit to that. And our expectation is if there is a foundation that's building to a bell course, that's building to a roof in West Grand Bahama and Bimini, and we could see reform. This is a community that existed like this from 2004. From 2004, just shy of 20 years. From 2004, West Grand Bahama sat like this. And now, if anything emerges out, I'm not talking about no government complex. I'm not talking about these things. Let's get deep into this. Abe Marakai School had significant mold. Okay? Mold. They had to do mold remediation back and forth. They got bats in the ceiling, all kind of things in Abe Marakai School. People are dealing with respiratory issues, so forth and so on. The next inevitable thing is either break the thing down, build a new school. Abe Marakai School, when I was going there, they built portions of that. We call it the new building. Abe Marakai High School had a commitment from persons in the Port Authority where they built a gym. They always was expanding in this area. And now, as a result of the decay that exists in this position, the next logical move is to build a school. This was envisioned, this was inevitable. If we see vision coming out of the ground being unearthed in West Grand Bahama, our expectation can be, I expect that to happen in my constituency. I expect the Prime Minister to make that same commitment in my constituency. The Prime Minister put too much on the table. He promised with everything that he had that he will do it. Now we got to see if he can do it. Let's take a telephone call. Caller on the line with us live. Go ahead. Next caller. Caller on the line with... Go ahead.
Hey, Howard.
Hey, what's up? Antoine, you gotta stop.
Okay, go ahead. Look here, Howard. Mm-hmm. You was on a roll just now with Dodd, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not the political part I'm interested in, but I just want to say a few words on the part relating to where we are and money, which is the same subject that God brought back in mm-hmm. from the other day, right?
Mm-hmm.
God.
You right here?
I'm listening.
How are you doing, Nicholas?
Always happy to hear from you.
Thank you, sir. Look, I agree with Howard. I wanna add to what Howard is saying that Parliament is the tool, God. That Parliament was the tool that was used back in Sir Lyndon and the Most Honorable Arthur Hanna's era. That Parliament is still the tool. We have lost our way along the way. But that Parliament is the tool that will flip the 5% who has the wealth, as you put it, the 15% who is overseeing and protecting the wealth or the wealthy in the country, and the 80% who, in many instances, don't see a way out or are striving to try and find a way out, like Howard always prescribes to, right? That Parliament is the tool that can make that happen overnight. Overnight. God. I'm to bring it back to what y'all just started on. I'll end right there with
mm-hmm.
what happened down there in that by election. That is the start of it. You had a single constituency.
That you can't help yourself, God. I don't know, you can't help yourself.
Go ahead, Anton.
You had a single constituency that got the full attention of the entire executive of the country, inclusive of the Minister of Finance and Prime Minister. Okay? As Howard was saying, once those promises and when those promises are delivered, and they will be delivered upon, that will mean empowerment for persons who are looking through their ceiling at the stars in the night, God. People who have to move from one side of the house to the next when it rains. That will mean empowerment for them, God. That will move them back to a level of comfort, and there's only upward movement to go from that point, God. And so, God. We're not all going to get to the top of the mountain at the same time, but God, the idea is to continually move everyone forward.
And sometimes it takes us to push
all people. Thank you, Howard.
Thank you. Sometimes it takes people us to push them. We ain't got to drag them up for a bit of rope when we get to the top. We could push them. I just listen to me. I may be naive, stupid. My wife could call me this all day, but she know where my convictions lie. I can't sleep over this. God, if I show you my vision book, excuse me, I can get in touch this with you. I got three books that I, one, I wake up and I write my dreams in it. I haven't done that for a very long time, right? Another one, when I sit down, from I was a child, from I was a little boy, I would daydream. My first grade teacher could tell you this. My parents could tell you this. I sit down and daydream it about ideas that could happen in my community. From I was a little boy, 4 or 5 years old, I keep thinking about innovation, ideas, creativity. I write these things down. I develop apps. I do all these things. I talk about these things. I got people on my team right now. I write these things down. I'm willing to die on that hill. A hill of pessimism, a hill of idealism, a hill that it's okay that I may be, you know, one in a million.
How about sometimes I say some things not because I want to spoon feed you or to spoon feed the people of the Bahamas, but I try to bring about a reactionary thought. You know, I want to stimulate your mind just a bit. But here's where I differ, and I will say this very strongly to everybody. I'm listening to Howard's story. I've learned who Howard Grant is, a man that I highly respect. Anton Thompson, you know how I feel about your family, but I'm going to disagree with you both. My strength for a nation has always been in the home, always, from the time I knew myself. And I know why I say this, because no government took care of me and my mother when my mother was a single mother, who dropped me to Busy Bee School opposite S.C. McPherson in a taxi cab, 35111. And she walked from Blue Hill Road over the hill down to Dowswell Street to Commonwealth Industrial Bank. My mother raised me into the man. And anyone who knows me could tell you I am all man. I stand on principles. I stand on truth. I stand on honesty. I stand on sacrifice. A Cub Scout always does his best, thinks of others before himself, and does a good deed every day. I have lived this. Money has never been my role model. I've always been a man for people. And for that, I may not have gotten the praise. I may not have gotten the reward. But guess what? I am one of the happiest people on God's earth that you will ever meet because of a good home. Whether it's a single parent home or two parents, from the home we built. Hold on, from a home. I'm telling you who I am now. Yeah, I'm going with
this. You didn't start the conversation like this.
I'm trying to tell you.
You start the conversation and you seek to elaborate on the fact that money matters.
I'm talking to you.
You never said money didn't matter.
Listen to what
you
I said.
You said that pessimism that continues to be able to leak into the conversation for growth for national change cannot be the conversation that we're having.
Howard.
Now you're telling me how you grow up at five.
Howard, I allowed you for your story because I wanted to bring you my story now and show you why I said what I said. But if you want to go on, you can go on. It's a Howard Grant show. I'm simply saying to you, Howard, that I transferred who I am into my community. And I tried to build a stronger community. We want leaders to come from out of our community to go into places like the House of Parliament to take the very truth that we stand for into our nation and take it internationally. That's how I see life. This is what I fight for. I'm like you. I'm unique, but this is what I fight for. I mentioned money to you because I've grown in a society, Howard, where everything that I've seen around me is marked by money.
I can fix this.
And I'm simply saying to you, I stand out only because I'm not of the same mindset. I do not buy into money. You cannot buy me. I am Garth Maynard Roseborough. You are Howard Grant. But until we change this mindset that money first and life second, I'm saying to you, we have a lot of work on our hand. That's all I'm simply saying to you,
I
sir.
Can help you and I can take a telephone
call. We got a lot of work to do.
It says money goes where money lies. That's something that we know.
That's what people say.
That's what people say. Let's fix this. Money goes where vision lies. That's where money goes.
Money goes where opportunity lies.
No.
Okay,
no,
good.
No.
I'm listening to you.
Money goes where vision lies. Vision.
Opportunity.
A concept and opportunity is inevitable. The opportunity will come, sir. The opportunity will come.
But not everybody buys into
vision. The formula for success is preparation plus opportunity equals success. Both the preparation and the opportunities are elements that leads to success. The opportunity is the one constant here.
Yes.
The opportunity will come.
Yes, opportunity.
Once you're prepared, the opportunity is inevitable. I don't care who you are. I don't care where you are. You could be a slumdog millionaire.
But you can choose the opportunity or reject it.
The opportunity will come.
But you can reject it, though.
If you seek success and you're prepared, you're going to find that when the opportunity arises. Some person's opportunities don't come.
Why?
Well, the reason that some persons may not necessarily see that particular opportunity because they're never prepared. They don't even know how to identify the opportunity.
Hello.
They don't even know that that's the opportunity.
Hello.
They don't know. So you're naive in this particular space. But let's be very clear about this.
I like this.
The only thing that is going to be a constant here is that money goes where vision lies. And if you want to take that political, if you want to take that in the church, if you want to take that whatever, the only time that investors, angel investors, the Bahamas Investment Authority, the Bahamas Development Bank, the Bank of the Bahamas, Commonwealth Bank, Scotia Bank, the only time they give you money is when you have vision.
So if we have a vision as a people, the money will come.
It's absolutely inevitable.
But preach it.
The money got to come.
But preach the vision.
But the fact of the matter is we are dealing with the foundation of preparation before the opportunity comes.
You like this. You like this.
We got to deal with preparation. You got to prepare yourself, your mind, your spirit, your education, and prepare yourself for when the money comes. Because when the money come, just like when you get $23 million from the World Development, from the IDB, to be able to open up your entrepreneur, you took that $5,000 and you went to Walmart. You ain't open up no business.
Now you're preaching.
You buys up the money.
Now you're teaching.
So don't say that the money is not going to come. Let's talk about education. Quick commercial break. Be right back after this.
The Foundation. We'll be back right after this.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and the generator's back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them at 242-356-0249.
Ciao! Fidelity Can On this year with their new festive giveaway. You could win cash, an iPhone 15, get a bill paid off, PS5, all kind of things. Apply for a loan or an ASUS savings account and you could win. Try our call them now. Yeah? 356-7764.
Always on the go? Missed the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Foundation. The Foundation. The Foundation. The foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take this telephone call. Call on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Hello.
Thanks so much for holding. Go ahead.
Good afternoon, Brother Grant.
Hey, what's up, my brother?
You know something?
Mm-hmm.
Brother God is right, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you why. You see the analogy he gave you with the 10%, the 15%, the 80%?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the 80%, they only want rum and chicken and promises that are comfort to fools. You understand me?
Why?
They ain't looking for nothing else.
Why?
And guess what? Let me show you another why, right?
I asked you why.
Right? Huh?
Why? Why are they only looking for that?
Because that's all they want.
No.
That's all they want.
No.
They're uneducated, and that's all they want.
That's wild that you said that.
Rum, chicken, and promises.
Wow. I appreciate your phone call. That's wild that he says this. Let's be very clear about something. 8 Mile Rock, over the past 19 years, have found itself in a very broken position. These are the people who built Freeport.
You told me.
These are the people, the West Grand Bahamian people, Turks Islanders, very talented people. Turks Islanders, the craftsmen. These are masons and so forth and so on in West Grand Bahama that built Freeport.
Good people.
The jewel of the entire region.
Good people.
They're decent people.
Mm-hmm.
They built Freeport.
Mm-hmm. And then they were discarded.
No, they wasn't discarded.
Okay.
Grand Bahama was able to take care of itself for some time. A transition came mm-hmm. where the introduction of the hurricane and a shift on top of what was happening with the housing bubble, all these things happened that shifted these people. And what they've done is made their entire life a life of service. These hotel people, all they had was their service. They haven't been educated to the point where they understand finances. They haven't educated themselves that they diversify anything. The concept of diversification only came 2 years ago, you know. Only 2 years ago, they've introduced that to the populace. It was one steady stream. Get a job. These are the people that you're dealing with. And so as a result of not being able to access a job because of the lack of opportunities, no airport, no hotel, no this, no that, what do? They turn to rum and chicken. The rum is to forget. The chicken is to sustain. Y'all need to stop how you talking about my people.
But there's always...
You need to stop how you talking about my people.
There's always a jewel in the rough, though. There's always good
You need to stop
people.
How you talking with my black Bahamian people who go through trials and tribulation. Nobody won't be in hell. Nobody.
Yeah, but nobody said...
These people drinking rum and praying to God to get out of it.
You know,
and when you hear a promise from the government, they cling to that. And in a moment of sobriety, they give the government an opportunity with bated breath. They hold their breath to hope to God that the prime minister stays true to his word and revives, restores, rejuvenates the community that once was the foundation, the blood, the sweat, the tears of the Magic City. Next telephone call, 30 seconds. Call, you got 30 seconds. Next telephone call, 30 seconds.
Jeez, time gone.
Next telephone call, 30 seconds. Hello? Next telephone call, 30 seconds. Hello?
Hello.
Hey, how you doing? You got 30 seconds? Hello? Next one. Go ahead.
Hey, give me a second. I'm a generator.
Hey, baby, go ahead. You got 30 seconds quickly.
Yeah, you was asking the gentleman why what he said. He said what he said. It's for instant gratification. They're not going to think about tomorrow. They're thinking about only for today. Because if they're going on the promises that were made in the by-election, they only need to look back at the promises made at the general election and see how much of them have so far come through, and that should have given them an answer. But mm-hmm. they're going into it, eyes closed, instant gratification, bottle in hand, and chicken bone on the ground.
That's it.
Right.
And I appreciate your telephone call. Mm-hmm. And then just somebody text me and say, Howard, why is only... Let me see if I can read this quickly. So it says, Howard, why do they only want rum and chicken? Because they have no vision. And where there is no vision, the people perish. Perishing is the opposite of thriving. There's a text that's coming through.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a proverbial. The chicken is sustenance. It's only food to be able to eat to sustain yourself because you mm-hmm. don't want to die.
Mm-hmm.
But the rum is for the inebriation. You need to forget. You need to be in a numb state to even survive. That's what we're dealing with. That's what we're dealing with. Let me see if I can take 30 seconds. 30 seconds telephone call. Call on the line with us live. Go ahead. Hello? Next telephone call. Call on the line with us live. Go ahead. One more. This is the last one. Go ahead.
Yes. Mr. God, Howard.
Yes, sir.
Yes. What I want to say is Obi was the type of person Obi was. He was somebody who people look up to, and it did not happen. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
It did not happen.
You mean for him?
It did not happen for him. All right? The reason for that was is that he wanted to become prime minister. So Brave cut him. All right? Meaning that they ain't gonna do nothing for him to make him look good. All right? And the next part of that is promise what he did for that place for out west, you know? Ain't nothing happened, buddy.
Wow. I appreciate your telephone call, ladies and gentlemen. That's the end of the show. I thank you so very kindly. Let's just be able to put this like this. Every single one of us. If you ask me to join your political organization and I come to your organization, I can play my role. I can do everything I have to do to sit in a strategic position and play my role. But every organization I've ever been a part of, I've always eyed moving to the top. That's just what it is.
But Howard, I want to say this quickly.
If you are a leader, you got to move up.
Howard, it doesn't matter where you are in the 80%. Understand whether you're 80 or 15, you can always move to the top. It's all up to you. It starts in your home.
I like that. I'm not going to fight you. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the show today. I want to thank you so very kindly for being able to tune in. It's a beautiful weekend. Make sure you take your sweet thing in the can out to watch a movie. Do something nice, man. Come on, man. I tell you, it's Christmas time. Stop looking at your finances and saying, I broke. Invest in happiness. Invest in joy. Take your sweet thing in the can out. Tell her wear a nice little pretty dress. Put on some cologne. Amen. Put her eyelashes on. Spend a couple dollars. Have a good time this weekend. We'll see you guys on Monday, God's Spirit Life, right here on The Foundation.
The Foundation.